But in drama, ah, even tranquility has to be recalled with emotion. Like touching a bare live wire. Try distancing yourself from that experience and writing about it. A mere description would be hopelessly inadequate. And for me, I have to relive the charge over and over again. Excuse me while I recharge myself. Yes, I have my memories. Locking myself in this bedsitter in a seedy suburb of London, thousands of miles from home, hasn't put enough distance between us. My battery charger helps on some occasions. But now, I want them back to masticate the memories in my mind and spit out the result to the world in anger. My progress so far, I must admit, has been zero. But I persist with the comforting thought that things can't get any worse. I keep staring at my typewriter every day, wondering how best to turn my anguish into drama. All I find, without fail, is just one typewritten sheet with the title of the play, my name, and the date. Nothing changes, except the date. Nana, a drama in two acts by Chandan Patel. Copyright, Chandan Patel. Today I made some progress. I even wrote my phone number. But that's all done with. Tonight, I drop everything I've desperately wanted to be in my years in England. And what remains is what I intend making capital of. My freakishness. Hi, I'm a freak. Now, a freak doesn't have to look too far for inspiration. But what is hard is to let go. Allow the memories to flood in. Tell you the truth, I'd even forgotten I had a twin sister. Until recently, when I thought of her as subject matter for my next literary attempt. Or maybe I didn't forget her. She was lying deep inside, out of reach.
Drink your milk, Amma.
Sorry, new place is slow down my peristalsis.
New pinch for new word.
Where are Tata's brass tumblers?
Oh, they have yet to be unpacked.
It's getting late for me.
Your father doesn't want us to use them. He doesn't want us to use any of your grandfather's things.
What are you saying, Bharti?
Now that we've moved out of his house, he doesn't even want to.
Just a minute. It was you who didn't want to unpack them. You said so yourself.
Me?
You said?
Why would I not want to use my own father's gifts to us?
Let me make this very clear. I have no reason to tell you not to use your late father's gifts. You're free to do as you please. In fact, it was you who didn't want to unpack them. So why are you?
Finish your milk.
I won't. Stop shoving it down my throat.
Nena.
Why did you serve her so much you didn't want to?
But she must put on more weight.
She's fine.
No. She's much too thin. She must put on more weight. Yesterday at the clinic, Dr. Kapoor checked their charts. She's lost half a pound in 1 week.
Half a pound isn't much.
In 1 month, she will lose a kilo. If I don't force her to eat, how will she gain weight? She will keep getting thinner till she's all shriveled and she's only skin and bones. It's bad enough that she... They... Nena, please.
Nena will be fine. They both are going to. They'll be fine.
But the doctors are concerned
about... I know. I know what the doctor said. Dr. Kapoor was surprised at their progress.
Surprised? Did you say...
I meant to say I was happy to note.
You said surprised.
I know I did. But I meant he was...
Or happily surprised?
Now don't start any sidey jokes.
Or maybe he was surprised that he was happy.
Enough! Enough!
He was pleased with their progress. Beyond everyone's expectations, he's going to mention them in a medical journal.
No! I don't want my children being mentioned in any medical journal.
Why? What's the harm? He'll only be read by the doctors. It might help him in such...
Just don't. That's all. I don't want all that publicity to start again.
It's only a journal. It won't. All right.
You will put on more weight, won't you, Nena?
I'll do anything you say, Mama. Except drink this milk.
Anyway. Anything you say, Naina. Anything.
Chandan.
Yeah?
I was just thinking, it may be a good idea for you to come to the office with me.
What for?
Just to get a feel of it.
You can take Naina. She'll make a great businesswoman.
How do you know?
Because you always cheat at cards.
Just because I win doesn't mean I cheat, okay?
Chandan, I think I must insist that you come.
We'll both come.
No. Yes, you. May both come if you want to.
No! No! That won't do! I can't have all that swimming in my head. The mind wanders too much. Unnecessary details, irrelevant characters, which don't figure anywhere. I've got to put it all down. I've got to make a start. Now steady. Steady, Dan boy. One thing at a time. Get to the desk. Sit on the chair. Put your fingers on the keys. Hand time. One can't have everything, can they? No. Wait. Let me think. What is Naina? Kind, gentle, strong. Her mother has given her the strength. And Dad? Silent, angry. Naina. She deserves something better. She never got a fair deal. Not even from nature. Neither of us did. Maybe God never wanted us to be separated. Maybe we were meant to die and our mortal remains preserved in formaldehyde for future generations to study. Her purpose in life was maybe that. Only that. But even God does not always get what he wants. Conflict is the crux of life. A duel to death between nature and God on one side and on the other, the amazing Dr. Iyer. Yes, you will be pleased to know that I have finally found my beginning. Good evening, viewers, and welcome to another edition of Marvels in the Wild of Medicine. We have with us in our studio this evening Dr. Srilakshmi Iyer, who has been in the news lately for her outstanding work at the Queen Victoria Memorial Hospital. During her stay at the hospital, Dr. Iyer was Surgeon-in-Chief to a most unique and complex surgery, the first of its kind in India. Dr. Iyer, could you tell us what was so special about this surgery?
To start with, the patients were only a few months old.
How old were they exactly?
Oh, 3 months.
3 months? Was the surgery really necessary?
Yes, absolutely. Surgery was their only chance of survival. You see, they were twins, conjoined from the chest down.
Siamese twins?
Yes, that's the common term used for them.
Is it a rare phenomenon?
Twins as such are not so rare. The chances...
What about Siamese twins?
Conjoined twins are quite rare. I think one in every 50,000 twin conceptions could have the probability of containing this defect.
And how does it happen?
Sometimes, we don't know why, a fertilized egg destined to separate and develop into two different embryos fails to do so fully. The result is a conjoinment. In this case, from the breastbone down to the pelvic area. It is indeed a miracle that the twins were born alive. Twins, with the conjunction of such complexity, are, in most cases, stillborn.
How many twins of this kind have actually survived through birth?
There are, I think, 7 registered cases in medical literature.
How many of them are still alive?
In all cases, one twin has always died by the age of 4.
Dr. Iyer, what is your opinion about the Patel twins? Will they survive?
You see, there is something even more remarkable about the Patel twins.
And what is that?
Conjoined twins, your Siamese twins, developing from one fertilized ovum are invariably of the same sex. Well, almost invariably. But in this case, these twins are obviously from two different eggs.
So?
They are of different sexes. Very, very rare.
A freak among freaks. Now I know I'll be a really brilliant writer.
I hate those girls.
What? Made friends already?
You must be joking. Oh, I love this part.
How was the physio?
Nice doctor. Rotten nurse. Not like Bangalore.
doctors, nurses, a painful necessity in our lives. Now comes the best part.
Mind you, some of the doctors aren't so painful to look at. This one's called Dr. Sandeep Shinde. He's handsome in a khaki sort of way.
In London, you swore you're going to marry that Irish doctor. What's his name? And you're only 12 then.
That was London. This is Bombay. One learns to love the natives. I know.
How can you know it 12? How can you know it 18?
Women mature fast. Speaking of maturity, you better not skip any of your physiotherapy sessions. Dad wants you to be big and sturdy. He'll find out from the hospital and...
It has passion. It has high quality of tragedy and romance, of youth bursting forth into the world with all its claims. A spring like...
When you become a writer, stay away from poetry.
It says so on the record now.
You mean you can feel all that in the music?
Well, the music is so... I don't know.
Mama?
In the kitchen. Where else? Showing the new cook how to make your favorite dishes.
I think I'm gonna like Bombay. It's also new and different.
We've been here before.
When? Oh, you mean?
Yes. The surgery was done. What's so funny?
Well, you could say that we were separated when we were babies in Bombay.
Separated. Oh, right. And we find each other again in Bombay.
Bhaiya.
Kevin, we are in Bombay. You just called me a doodwal.
Oh, Chandu, what would I do without you?
Nana, stop saying such things.
I'd probably have a ball. That's what I would do. Having both mum and dad dancing around me all the time. Yes, Nana. No, Nana. Anything you say, Nana.
They do that now.
Well, Mama, yes. But it's okay. I can take it. I'm a big girl now.
No, it's not okay. You can't take it. You're still a small girl with a wild imagination.
Women have an instinct for such things.
Women, not girls.
It's innate. We're born with it.
Okay, okay. I leave you to your instincts. The world of Brahms awaits me.
Nalini and Prema. They live in the building opposite. Had another friend with them, equally ugly. They were all running across the street, laughing their ugly heads off for something. When they saw me get out of the car, they stopped. They stopped running and they stopped laughing and waited for me to get off and walk across the footpath towards them, embarrassing me, making me go slower than I would. When I reached them, they grinned. Nalini whispered something to her ugly friend. I knew what was coming. Might as well play along, I thought. I smiled and introduced myself. We exchanged names. Nalini and Prema. The other one just tittered. I smiled to her as well. Then I showed it to them. The duckling couldn't believe her eyes. They stared at my leg, felt it, and knocked on it. Silly as well as ugly, I thought. The very best from Jaipur, I said. We get them in pairs. My twin brother wears the other one.
You did it.
Then, they ran off, pleased with themselves, laughing even harder. Their day was made. One of these days. I'm going to tell them exactly how frightful they look.
Maybe they already know.
Still, it would be nice to see their reaction. Play the music real loud.
Peas in pods.
Huh?
Two peas in a pod? That's something we aren't.
Yes, yes. Very funny.
Funny? I didn't think so.
You know, two peas in a pot? Isn't that funny? Yes, yes. Of course. Very funny. Two peas in a pot?
Oh, yes. Very funny. I've got to go write something down. Two peas in a pot. What?
Well, oh, don't mind. It's just some silly family joke. Very silly, if you ask me. Yes, yes. So, tell me something about yourself. Which standard are you in?
I just finished my 10th. And you?
Oh, we just finished our 12th. The results aren't out yet.
Where are you from?
Bangalore.
Oh, really? We are Kannadigas too. My mom's from Bangalore.
Oh, which part?
Well, Tomko really. But I was born here.
My mom is from Bangalore. My dad's Gujarati.
Oh, an intercaste marriage. Was it a love marriage? Tell, tell.
My dad had to leave his, parents because of this marriage. If you really want to know.
No, I didn't mean to be nosy or anything. But don't stop now.
There's nothing much to tell. My grandfather, my mother's father, was a very influential person. But my dad didn't take any help from him. Today he's the general manager of Indosweet Pharmacia, the biggest pharmaceutical company in the country. Heard of it?
Yes, I love their cough syrups.
Very soon he's going to be one of the directors.
That's great. So, you're going to do your graduation here in Bombay?
Well, I don't know.
What do you mean? Aren't you going to live here?
Yes, but very soon I'll be going in for surgery.
Oh, how sad. On your leg?
No, a kidney transplant.
Gosh!
It's okay. We knew about it before. I was kind of prepared.
Does your brother also?
Oh no! He's fine. Thank God for that.
Don't you, you know, need someone to give you a kidney?
A donor? Yes, I've got one.
Your brother?
No!
Your dad?
you like Chinese for dinner? Ida says chow mein is her specialty. Oh, how I miss Gopi. Maybe I should call Badivaka and ask her to send him after all. Oh, hello. I see you made friends already.
Hello, Auntie. Hey, Gidara.
A Kannadiga for a neighbor in Bombay. How refreshing. Especially since we had all those Gujarati neighbors in Bangalore.
Oh, we have them here too.
Well, sit down.
Rupa.
Rupa. Well, I mustn't interrupt you two from... Nena, what is Chandan up to?
I think he's writing.
That boy. Let me see if he needs anything.
Well, I better get going.
If you need my old notes or textbooks or anything, just ask.
Right. And stay away from Prema and Nalini. They will be nasty to you.
It's okay. I can handle them.
That's what you think. And besides, they're not really a standard. Their English isn't that good. They won't understand your jokes like peas and pots and all that.
Well, we'll teach them.
You'll be wasting your time. And personally, I think they're really vantara.
Vantara?
All types. Don't you know Kannada?
Oh, Vondu Tara. I know what you mean.
Well, forewarned is forehanded. So take care. Bye.
Nena, you haven't finished unpacking. The green suitcase is still lying there.
It's got all my old things.
Go do it now.
It'll probably take a whole day.
Okay.
Okay, Rupa. Bye. Come anytime.
Bye. Well, Bartini, Auntie.
No, stay for a while, please.
No, it's okay. You must have a lot of work to do.
That's okay. Sit down.
No, it's okay.
Sit down.
Okay, if you say so.
Nena is a very nice girl.
Yes, such a nice girl.
You will be her friend.
Yes, yes.
She must make more friends. Chandan is all right. He has his writing. But she... He is different, you know, sort of self-contained. But Nena... She can be very good company and she has her talents. She can be very witty and of course she is intelligent. And I have seen to it that she more than makes up in some ways for what she doesn't have.
Yes, that she does.
So you will be her friend?
Yes, if you say so.
You will be her best friend?
I don't know. Prema and Nalini are my best friends.
If you promise to be her best friend, what I mean is, if you would like to be her friend, I will be most grateful to you. And I will show it in whatever way you want me to.
I don't think I understand.
Do you have a VCR at home?
Yes.
Oh. So you must see a lot of films.
Oh, not a lot. My mother only allows me to watch movies on Sunday afternoons.
So there must be a lot of films you're dying to see.
Yes, plenty.
Well, you can watch them here. Anytime you want to. No restrictions.
I don't know what my mother would say.
How will she know?
Can I watch Basic Instinct?
You can watch whatever you want. Just be my Nena's friend.
Okay. Can I go now?
Yes. First, promise me that you will be her friend.
Look, I think about it.
Promise me now.
Look, I'll come again. I promise.
Yes, of course. I mean, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to force anything on you.
It's okay. I understand. I'll come again.
Yes,
bye.
Please, do come.
I will. Bye. is really fun, Tara. I don't think I'll be going there again.
The parents were warned of the odds against survival. They were, understandably, totally disheartened in the beginning. But soon, even the remotest chance of survival was received with hopes once they were made aware of the facilities offered by modern technology. I had a conference with the resident doctors of the Victoria Hospital, a very efficient and competent team of doctors. I was shown the test reports, x-rays, scan results from the Bangalore Hospital. A lot of points had to be reconfirmed and further observations were necessary before taking any decisions on surgery. The twins were flown in from Bangalore and they were sent immediately to the intensive care unit. They had their further observations and tests. It was 2 weeks of exhaustive work. But the results were encouraging. They did not shed any vital organ. There were 2 hearts, clearly indicated by 2 electrocardiograms. There were 2 livers, although joined. Each twin would have 1 kidney. All this meant that there was a very strong possibility of both twins surviving. What we needed to know more about was the pelvic region and the extent of conjoinment there.
Yes, Dr. Kapoor. I'm happy to hear that. Indeed, she's a very lucky girl. Yes, as soon as possible. Well, after all that she's been through so far, anyway, she'll be glad she won't have to go for a dialysis after the surgery. Oh, don't worry, Doctor. She's a very high-spirited girl. Knowing her, she'll probably just joke about it. And her brother gives her enough moral support. Yes, I'll call you tomorrow. Thank you, Doctor. Thank you.
So, everything is all right. We are compatible. I think God wanted it this way.
Bharti, you cannot give her your kidney.
What? But just now on the phone you were making preparations.
Naina is very lucky. She has found another donor.
A commercial donor?
Yes.
Why? What is wrong? Why can't she have mine?
You can't. That's all.
You won't let me. I'm going to call Dr. Kapoor right away and tell him to make the arrangements.
It's no use, Bharti.
You can't stop me from doing what I want.
Put the phone down, Bharti.
How dare you run my life?
Oh God, you're getting out of hand.
Oh God, what is his number?
Calm down, Bharti.
His number? Give me his phone number.
I will not.
Well, I will look it up.
You don't even know his full name.
But I can call.
Who? Bharti, stop pretending! You're in no condition of taking major decisions!
Give me his phone number.
I can give his number. But I'll not let you donate a kidney to her.
Just show that I could do it. There is nothing wrong with it.
Yes, it is wrong. Now that we have a donor, I'll not let you do it.
But think of the expenses involved.
Where have expenses ever bothered you? Your father's wealth has always been a friend against me. Don't talk about expenses to me.
Why won't you let me do it?
Because did I tell you? Because I don't want you to have the satisfaction of doing it.
I will.
You will have to obey me. My turn now.
But I want to give her a part of me.
Now listen. You need help. I'm going to arrange for a doctor to examine you thoroughly.
I'm fine. I don't need a doctor. My blood pressure's under.
I mean a psychiatrist.
I don't need one.
It can't do any harm.
Tell you I don't need one. You're wasting your time.
Think about Naina and Chandan.
I am thinking about them. That's why I need to make you more stable.
Look, I'm perfectly all right. Don't worry about me.
I cannot handle your moods any longer. Have you looked at yourself recently? Look at the way you behave, the way you react to.
I promise to control myself.
I know you want to. But can you?
Just let me do.
Anything will allow you to.
Who are you to stop me? Just who do you think you are?
Sit down, Bharti.
This is no way to treat me.
Sit down. Now listen. I'm going to fix an appointment for you. And you're going to see that doctor.
I don't want to. I don't need to.
You will. I demand it from you.
All right. You want me to be all right? Yes.
Good. I'm going right now. You wouldn't dare tell them. Not you. Please, don't. Not yet.
Then let me do what I want to do.
You cannot tell them. For their sake, don't. If at all they must know, it'll be from me, not from you.
Watching here?
Yes, I didn't think of that. Well, I better get going.
I'll come out with you.
Bye, Auntie. Thank you for the movies and the coffee.
Don't mention it.
Bye, Chandan. Let me read your story sometime. I hope I'm in it.
Don't worry. You are.
Well,
probably something you haven't figured out yourself.
I beg your pardon. Don't think you are very smart.
Only in comparison.
Since you insist, I'll tell you. It may not be true, but this is what I've heard. The Patels in the old days were unhappy with their girl babies. What with dowry and all that. So they used to drown them in milk.
In milk?
Yes. So when people asked how the baby died, they said she choked while drinking her milk.
How absurd.
Silly, isn't it?
Absolutely hilarious.
What a waste of milk.
So is this what Mama was trying to stop you from telling me?
Yes.
Mama is so cute sometimes.
Yes.
When we were young, I used to be quite a sick child.
What with all your problems?
And it was always I who got all her love and attention.
That must have made poor Chandan quite jealous.
A little bit, I suppose. But he's always been so... He's never really asked for much. He's been so happy with so little. I have always demanded more and more.
It pays sometimes to be the sickly one.
I always used to play hard to get, sulking all the time. When I smiled, it made everyone quite relieved. As if I didn't smile, I would just curl up and die. Mama always said that my eyes really twinkled when I smiled.
Twinkle, Lena. That's really cute. So, did your father spoil you just as much?
I don't remember.
Mommy, is that a sweater you're knitting for Nana?
Yes.
You've dropped a stitch.
Hey, Daddy.
Hey, Nana. How's the day?
Good.
So, what is the whole day?
Nothing much. Watch movies.
The whole day?
Hmm.
And Chandan?
Him too.
And her mother?
Well, you know how she is. You can't really say what she's doing.
Hello.
Hi, Dad.
What are you doing?
Mummy is knitting and I'm helping her sort out a mistake.
Let Nana do it.
It's okay.
Give it to her.
Why?
It's all right. I'll manage. Leave it.
I'll just roll this and...
Chandan! Leave that damn thing alone.
Chandan, go. Just go.
How dare you do this to him?
Wait a minute, Daddy. Mummy didn't ask
me to... Can't even look after the children.
Daddy, it's...
What did you do the whole day, huh? Watch movies?
I can't think of things for them to do all the time.
But you can think of turning him to a sissy, teaching him to knit.
Daddy, that's unfair.
Chandan, please go to your room.
All I was doing was helping Mummy to...
Chandan, I'm disappointed in you. From now on, you come to the office with me. I can't see you running at home.
I don't want to go to office.
You will come to office with me until college begins.
I don't want to go to college. Not without Nana. If she's going in for surgery, I'll miss a year too.
You will not. I won't allow it.
I'm not going to go out to college without Nana.
That would make me very unhappy.
Well, that's too bad. That's just too bad.
Say it. Go on, say it. That it's all my fault. That I'm turning the children against you.
You're turning them against the whole world.
I'm doing that?
Yes. Look at the way you treat Nana. As if she's made of glass. You coddle her, you pet her, you spoil her. She's gone her feelings. She doesn't need anyone else but you.
What?
do you want me to do? Just tell me in plain, simple words what you want me to do and I'll do it.
Let go. Just let go. And let me handle them.
All right. You stay home then. You stay at home and watch what they can do and watch what they can't. You remind them of what they can be. It's all very easy for you to talk about their future and your plans. But tell them what they should do now. This day, this hour, this minute. Tell them, I want to hear.
Chandan is going to study further. He's going abroad for his higher studies.
And Naina?
Then have you ever allowed me to make any plans for her?
I'm stopping you from making plans for your daughter.
Don't lie, Bharti. You don't want me to. And you know it. You've told me so a dozen times.
That is not true.
You have to face it, Bharti. You want her to believe that you're the only one who loves her.
Why? Why would I want that?
You don't want to say it, do you? And you threaten me that you'll tell him? But he won't. You can't. You don't know what you want.
Just leave me alone with my daughter.
Is that what you want? To love her?
Ask her.
You said your love will make up for the lot, didn't you?
Ask her what she wants and give it to her.
You're sure she loves you? Don't make her choose between us, for God's sake. You're ruining her life because you're sick. I want to help you, Bharti. Please allow me to help you.
I don't need your help.
Look at you. Do you ever go out? No. Have you made any friends? No. We've been here for 2 months and you haven't even talked to anyone. You just sit here rotting.
I don't need anyone.
Exactly. That's what I want from you. Don't make my children say that.
I'm not doing that. I have always made sure that Naina has had friends. Why that Rupa? She... What you're saying just isn't true. You cannot lie about me like that in front of my children. Now that they're at such an impressionable age and might take your words very seriously.
Oh, how deviously clever you are. I'm the liar. I'm the one who's feeding them with lies when they're at an impressionable age. I'm the violent one. And you're the victim of my wrath. You don't go out because I don't let you. Go out, say it!
Stop it! Stop this madness and let me live in peace.
How can I? Not now when I'm turning my own children against me.
You said it. I knew you would say it. Go on, say it again. I don't care. After all these lies you have said about me.
Yes, call me a liar, a wife beater, a child abuser. That's what you want me to be. And you want them to believe that you love them very much.
Yes, I do.
Look at her, Bharti. Look at her and tell her that you love her very much.
Naina knows it. Leave her alone. Daddy.
Naina. Please believe me when I say that I love you. I love you very much. And I've never in my life loved you less or more than I've loved your brother. But your mother...
Stop it! Don't fill her with nonsense about me.
But your mother would like you to believe that it's not true. I love you. We both do.
Bharti sobs. Patel brings in the revived Naina. Patel picks up the phone and dials the hospital. The act ends with the explosive opening of Brahms' first concert. I was looking through this old scrapbook, a present Daddy gave me just before I left. It's got all our news cuttings. Dr. Iyer is in the headlines. Then the interviews with Mom and Dad. And worst of all, a hideous photograph of us. Before and after. I don't think the Elephant Man got so much publicity. Two tiny, smaller than life babies, hugging each other. Only a closer look. Here's the one I'm looking for. The Patel twins still twinkling. The Patel twins made medical history today by being the longest surviving pair of Siamese twins. Nana Patel, who underwent her 7th prosthesis and a kidney transplant in the same month, was jovial within hours of a complex surgery. Surgery is like brushing our teeth, joked the twins. Nana Patel, whose recovery was nothing short of a miracle, states that the source of her strength was her mother and, of course, her brother and father. Mrs. Bharti Patel, however, was too indisposed to give an interview. A distraught Mr. Patel explained that this had been a trying time for her. For in spite of the brave facade put up by her, Nana's condition had far too many complications for her to be safely out of danger. However, the will to survive has proved to work more miracles than the greatest of science. Etc., etc. Poor Nana. Even nature gave her a raw deal.
Complications were expected. Our team of doctors were aware of that. The pelvic region, as I had mentioned before, was the problem. There was only one bladder and it belonged to the boy. So did the rectum. We would have to have an artificial one made for the girl. Later on, when she grows up, we can fashion one from her intestinal tissues. The boy's lungs weren't fully developed, but considering the magnitude of the work involved, this is just a minor detail. The prognosis, on the whole, was favorable to both. Nature had done a near complete job. Medical science could finish it for her. Theoretically, the separation was possible.
Welcome back!
Welcome back, Nana!
Thank you! Thank you, good people! First of all, I'd like to thank my agent. People here, my mom and dad, and to my wonderful brother, without whose glorious presence this operation would never have been made.
How true!
Oh no, thanks. Video services have been terminated.
Oh.
For the day.
Oh, right. We'll watch something better tomorrow. Like Twins?
Where's Mama? Still after Eid, I suppose. Making something special for us.
Nena, now take this to your room and wash up. You can chat with a friend later.
My, oh my. You sound just like Mama. You men can imitate us so well if you want to. Pity, we can't return the compliment.
We'll tell her after she settles down.
You mean she still doesn't know?
We haven't told her yet.
Surely she must have asked for her.
It happened while she was in searching.
Rupa, I think it'll be better if you left. Just for now. You're most welcome to come back later.
Okay. In case she needs me, just give me a shout. Or send her over. I'll comfort her.
Thank you.
Bye, Chandan. Bye, Uncle. Prema, are you there?
Oh, this is great. Mama doesn't even come to say hello.
Nena.
Run and get it for me.
Very funny.
Nanni, Rupa, Prema.
Quite a clear sky. No moon, no...
Shooting stars to make wishes on.
How true! Oh, I wish there was one.
Make your wish anyway.
What would you wish for?
I would wish for the stars. And you?
Me?
Jaipur legs?
No, silly. No real ones.
Nana? Don't cry.
I miss Mama so much.
The separation itself was quite complicated. The pelvis had to be fractured at several places to facilitate separation. Cutting the two livers apart was an extremely delicate job. We had to be careful not to damage the bile ducts. We had had about 6 rehearsals with dummies to make sure that every detail was considered. In terms of the physical movements of the surgeons during the operation, as well as the surgical procedure.
Girl and a boy, who would you choose?
A boy? Definitely.
Definitely?
Yes. It's bad enough going to an all-girls school. I would definitely want a boyfriend.
No, I didn't mean that.
Then what did you mean?
I meant a son and a daughter.
A boy child and a girl child. Say that.
Who would you choose?
I would be happy with either one.
That's not the point. In the film, I mean. The Nazis will allow her to keep only one child. The other one would be sent out to a concentration camp or something.
How nasty are the Nazis?
Would you send your girl child to a concentration camp?
Definitely not. I think it's much more civilized to drown her in milk. Anyway, who cares? I've got plenty of time for all that. I'm just 17, you know. Right now, I'd settle for a boyfriend. Chandan, do you have any girlfriends?
No.
Well, would you want one?
I don't know. What will I do with one?
I don't believe this. Didn't you go to a co-ed school in Bangalore?
Yes.
Well, wasn't there one girl who you were close to? Someone who you shared your homework with? Or someone who you sat next to in class?
Yes.
Yes? You did?
Of course, Nana.
She doesn't count.
What did you say?
I said she doesn't count. She's a sister. What I meant was, she doesn't count in this department.
I understand.
I was just wondering, where is she?
She's gone for her physiotherapy.
Don't you have to go as well?
I do. But I don't.
Why?
I just don't. Hospitals depress me.
Oh, I know what you mean. My cousin Saraswati had her appendix removed. I had to spend the entire night with her at the hospital. Her mom was tired, and this is the least I could do. Oh God, the smells, the chloroform and the DDT. I just threw up. Poor Saraswati had to help me go to the bathroom. After that, I swore I'd never go to the hospital again. How's your mother? Is she going to be all right? When is she coming back?
I hate the hospitals. The smells, the people, the sterility.
Deepna,
Deepna?
My classmate in school.
Standard 8, her best friend?
Not in the beginning, she wasn't. Used to sit right next to me because Mrs. Ramanathan, our science teacher, asked her to. Never talked to me until Radbat. Mrs. Ramanathan paired us off for some stupid project. Wanted us to make a model of solar system or something as a homework. I thought I'd rather go to her house than call her home. She didn't like the idea. So Radbat decided for us. Deepna then had to take me home with her. So we sat on her bed, making our model with rubber balls and wires. Her bed felt different somehow. So I put my hand under the cover and guess what?
What?
There was a rubber sheet underneath. 13 years old and she was wetting her bed. I laughed.
She became her best friend.
Well, I didn't tell anyone at school. But she knew I could easily have done so, even at the slightest provocation. I soon had her doing all my homework.
I don't think that. Why are you telling me this?
It's good to know what hurts other people.
I guess.
Comes in handy.
Well, I suppose so.
Knowing their secrets is useful.
I guess so.
So, how does it feel having one tit smaller than the other? Oh, don't worry. It's not very noticeable. Except from a certain angle. Then, it's very noticeable.
How dare you, you one-legged thing?
I'd soon be one-eyed, one-armed, and one-legged. Then be an imbecile like you. An imbecile with uneven tits.
And to think I pity you. Oh, I think you're disgusting. I only came here because your mother asked me to. No, she didn't ask me. She bribed me to be her best friend. Yes, your loony mother used to give me things. Charlie bottles, magazines, lipsticks. Now that she's gone completely loony, I don't think she'll be giving me much. So goodbye!
Get lost! And please ask Nalini and Prema to come here! I have something to say to them! About you! Oh, wait till they hear this! They will love it! They are gonna look at your tits the same way they... They looked at my leg! You won't be able to come out of your house, you horrible creature! You're ugly! And I don't want ugly people in my house! So get lost!
They are not the ugly ones. We are horrible one-legged creatures.
Yes, but you don't have to say it.
I'm sorry, Naina, but you mustn't mind very much.
What?
Being one-legged.
What makes you think I mind?
I can feel your pain, Naina. I can feel your pain.
Yes. I do mind. I mind very much.
That's a very interesting question. You see, due to the complex conjoinment at the pelvic region, it's very difficult to say how their reproductive organs would develop. A lot depends on the hormone levels that their body would be able to produce. Imbalances are highly probable. But enough research has been made on the subject. With necessary supplements, it isn't unreasonable to expect them to have a fairly normal growth otherwise. Of course, it would be impossible for either of them to be able to reproduce. they're completely sterile.
Maybe I can dedicate the rest of my life to serve others. That might give purpose to my existence. I can do that. I can do that, can't I? Because if I could, that would make me really happy. Because that is something that I really want. That is something that I really... Oh, bullshit! I don't care. I don't care for anyone except Mama.
It's somehow wrong.
I don't care.
You should. You should care. For the people around you.
How do you expect me to feel anything for anyone if they do not give me any feeling to begin with? Why is it wrong for me to be without any feeling? Why are you asking me to do something that no one else has ever done for me?
I don't know. But it's somehow wrong to be so selfish.
Selfish? Yes. I am. I have the right to be selfish like everyone else.
No, you don't. We don't. We are not like everyone else.
I think that bothers you more than it bothers me.
I'm not being bothered by anything.
But it bothers me to hear you preaching to me what is wrong and what isn't.
All right. I won't. You can do whatever you want. And just maybe I will help you do whatever you want.
Oh, don't bother. You're not my big brother, okay? I can teach you a trick or two if I want to.
Oh, sure. Women mature faster.
Yes, we do. We do. And we are more sensitive, more intelligent, more compassionate human beings than dreams like you and Daddy!
Hello? Hello? Dad? Can you hear me? Dad? Hello, operator. Can you give me India 022-654-4423, please? I'm having trouble getting through to Bombay. Yes, I'll hold. Thank you. Hello, Dad. This is Chandan. Praful uncle called me. I believe you called him. Yes. I received your letter. Mummy's been admitted in the hospital again. I know. If you have something to say to me, you should call me and not uncle. Well, I take it off the hook sometimes when I'm writing. What is it, Dad? How's Mummy? How? When was this? Was it sudden? I'm sorry, Dad. But I can't help feel relieved that it's all over. No. Look, I can understand how you feel. And I know I must be there with you right now. But please don't ask me to come back. Well, I'm in the middle of writing something, but that's not it. It's just that I can't face life there anymore. Oh, why don't you come here? Your brothers are all here. And me. Not that I'll be able to give you much. I was never a giver. No. I never blame you for anything, Dad. How can you think it was your fault? Don't talk about her. It's not fair to me. Nana has been dead for 6 years now. And now that mommy is gone as well, there is nothing left for me to come back to. Maybe I'm hurting you deliberately. I don't know why, but I can't help the way I feel. Either you come here or live by yourself in Bombay. Well, that's too bad. That is just too bad. I don't like hospitals.
I know. They depress you.
I'll go. Soon.
You've just come with us once.
I'll come this Sunday. Mummy isn't feeling any better. I know. You can visit her more often if you want to.
I want to.
Who's stopping you?
Daddy.
Why? I think you're being unfair to him.
You are always defending him.
No, I'm not. He's not what you make him out to be.
You say that because he's nice to you.
He's nice to you.
He talks to you more often.
All right. He talks to me. But he's nice to you.
I tell you. He hates me.
Nobody hates you, Naina.
I hate him.
Why?
Chandan, I did not go to the physiotherapist today.
Where did you go then?
To the hospital.
What? Why didn't you tell me?
I just decided on the way. I asked the driver to take me there instead. I wanted to talk to her. Alone.
Well, what happened?
Chandan, I must meet her alone.
But didn't you meet her?
They wouldn't let me.
They who?
The hospital staff. At the reception, they asked me who I wanted to see. I told them. They asked me to wait. One of the nurses passing by recognized me. She drew the receptionist aside and spoke to her in a low voice. She thought I couldn't hear what she was saying, but I heard. She said that she had strict instructions from her father that I shouldn't on any account be allowed to see Mama on my own.
He must have a reason. Maybe he feels your presence upset Mummy in some sort.
I would upset Mama?
Just a possibility. I didn't mean to say that.
So it's me, is it? I am the one upsetting her. Your daddy is blameless. Maybe I'm stupid. I must be complaining to the life party.
Maybe you should be the writer. What with your wild imagination? Don't expect me to take your side. I'll quarrel on your behalf. I don't think I should encourage you.
Okay. Don't believe me. All I want is your help in getting me alone with Mama so that I can talk to her.
But how can I do that?
I don't know. Maybe next time we go visit the hospital, you can distract Daddy. Pretend you're having another attack or something.
And then? she'll disclose a dark secret to you. What do you think she'll tell you anyway?
She'll tell me about him.
I don't think I can do it. Maybe it's for the best.
What?
If Daddy is stopping Mummy from telling something to us, maybe it's not good for us to know it.
And who decides what's good for us to know and what isn't?
Whatever it is, if at all it exists, Daddy will tell us when we're good and ready.
Will he?
Trust him. He will.
What if the secrets concern him? Will he tell us then?
Making a mountain of it.
I don't think you care for us.
Wait a minute. That is silly.
You don't care for me. And you don't care for Mama. You don't even come to see her. As far as you are concerned, she's already dead.
That's not true.
Post-operative care needed just as much planning. Other operations may have to be done when the children grow up. The important thing is, the separation was a complete success.
No, no, please. We'll ask him tomorrow.
Tomorrow may be too late.
He's disturbed enough.
I am disturbed! How dare he stop us? Daddy,
you look very tired, Dad.
Oh, it's just the heat and the traffic.
Are you feeling all right?
Oh, don't worry about me. Did you two go to physiotherapy?
Well, I didn't. Sorry.
And Nana?
She went, I think.
Did she or didn't she? I had sent a car for both of you.
The car came. She went.
What's wrong with her? Can't she speak for herself? Did you go to physiotherapy? Nana, I'm talking to you.
No! I didn't go. I went to the hospital.
Don't ever go there without my permission.
Very well. I am asking for your permission to go there tomorrow.
We'll all go.
On my own.
Never!
Oh, it's no use! I am going to hate you anyway!
Prema, Nalini, are you ready? Let's teach that bitch a lesson.
We are going there tomorrow without your permission.
You will not!
Chandan, will you come with me?
Chandan, you can't!
Chandan?
No! Don't go!
We'll both go.
Our greatest challenge was to keep the girl alive. Nature wanted to kill her. We couldn't allow it.
Nana, come on out. We want to talk to you.
All right.
So we can go?
No. I don't want her to have the satisfaction of confessing. Oh God, why didn't I have the strength to stop her then?
What's the matter? Are you scared? Come on out.
I suppose we both were to blame. Your mother and I. And a grandfather. My father was a wealthy man, an industrialist, and an MLA. He would have been the chief minister had he lived. He had power. parents were more orthodox. They didn't approve of our marriage. I broke away from them. Ours was a happy marriage. We were all overjoyed when they came to know that Bharti would have twins. Until they came to know the complications.
You can't hide in a house forever. You have to come out.
We didn't expect you to survive. But you did. When I first saw you, you looked like two babies hugging each other. It was only in a loser look. We were not prepared for the worst. Until we came to know Dr. Iyer, who was visiting India. She had done research abroad on such cases. I came here to Bombay to meet her and discussed your case. There was hope.
Both twins have only one leg each. The artificial limb center at Jaipur was contacted and suitable flexible legs would be provided when they are slightly older. They have to be changed from time to time as the children grow up.
What's the matter? Are you deaf as well? Come on out, you freak!
Grandfather got involved personally in that discussion with the doctor. The separation, it would be done in Bombay, it was decided. There were certain tests that had to be done immediately. There were problems. But there was one complication that hadn't been discussed. There were three legs.
All right, stay inside. We are going to get a present for you.
A scan showed that a major part of the blood supply to the third leg was provided by the girl. Your mother asked for a reconfirmation. But the result was the same. That the chances were slightly better that the leg would survive. Look at the girl. Your grandfather and your mother, they had a private meeting with the doctor. I was even asked to come. That same evening, your mother told me of her decision. Everything would be done as planned. Except I couldn't believe what she told me. That they would risk giving both the legs to the boy. Maybe if I had protested more strongly. I tried to reason with her that it was wrong. And even the doctor would realize that it was unethical. But the doctor had agreed. I was told. Only later I came to know of the intention of starting a large nursing home, the largest in Bangalore. Your grandfather's political influence had been used. A few days later, the searching was done, as planned by them. Chandan had two legs, but only for 2 days. It didn't take them very long to realize what a grave mistake they had made. The leg was amputated. A piece of dead flesh that could have, might have been Nana. It was easy to pass it off as a natural rejection. I was meaning to tell you both when you hold up, but...
Thank you very much, Dr. Iyer. It's been a real pleasure. Now go! Just go away! Get out of my mind, you horrible creature! You're ugly! And I don't want ugly people in my head! Give me a moment, and the pain will subside. Then I'll be able to function again. Yes, yes. The material is there, but the craft is yet to come. Like the amazing Dr. Iyer, I must take something from Nana and give it to myself. Make capital of my trauma, my anguish, and make it my tragedy. To masticate them in my mind and spit out the result to the world in anger. My progress, so far, I must admit, has been zero. All I find every day is just one typewritten sheet. The title of the play, my name, and the date. Nothing changes except the date.
And me, maybe I still am, in spite of all that has been, lying deep inside, out of reach.
Money. So, thank you very much for sitting so patiently and in what some would call a pretty long play. So, hope you didn't feel that way. So, we'd like to move on and introduce our very talented cast.
Amazing cast, actually.
Yes. So, moving in order of appearance, Dan, Urf Chandan, was played by Funny Kishan. Bharti was played by Monisha. Dr. Iyer, played by Niveta. Patel, played by Aseem Nasnokar.
Team Angani.
Rupa, played by Komal Agarwal. And finally, the protagonist, Naina. Played by Namrata Agarwal. Thank you very much. And it has indeed been a very enriching experience for us. Before we move on,
the music director, Sachit Handa. And lights were Dhananjay and Harsh. We call him DJ the Oscar.
Sir.
And prodheads KP, Kanupriya and Zubin.
They're probably already busy getting dismantling the set.
Yeah. And finally, this amazing set prepared by Jolly Ma'am. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, and it would not have been possible without the support of the dram cell. Entire dram cell, PG1, PG2s. And also, yeah, yeah, PGP3s as well. Their contribution was actually very necessary. And you all, amazing audience. Thanks a lot.
That's it from us. Thank you.
Of course, our very able directors, Harsh Mishra, who we during the course of practice believe that he has found new love. And of course, Mani, the Superman Prakash. Thank you very much. And we would like to also thank one very important person, Mr. Rais Sheikh, wherever you are, please do come onto the stage. Rais Sheikh, sir. Oh, he has already gone back to Ullas, so commitment issues are there. Oh, he's back, sir.